Welcome back to STS. In today's video, we're going to find all of the solutions of this trig equation. And here we have 2 times sine x plus root x is equal to 0. First thing we need to do is get the sine x on one side and get all the other terms and factors moved to the other side. We're going to begin by subtracting a root 2 from both sides of this equation. Alright, in doing so, the root 2's here cancel, and I have 2 sine x is equal to negative root 2. Now I have a factor of 2 here on the left hand side I'm going to divide out. When I do that, these 2's cancel, and here you see I have sine x is equal to negative root 2 over 2. Next thing I want to do here is I want to rationalize, because I want to get this root 2 out of the numerator, because I don't see what special triangle I may have here. By rationalizing, it's going to make it more clear what that special triangle is. So I multiply my numerator and denominator by root 2. I have a negative out front, but the square root of 2 times the square root of 2 is the square root of 4, and the square root of 4 is 2. And then my denominator, I have 2 times root 2. Here I notice I have factors of 2 that can cancel, so I'm left with a negative 1 over root 2. Now it's more clear what the special triangle is, but let's also take a moment and look at the relationship for sine. We know that sine theta is equal to the y value divided by the r value, and in this particular example we see that that sine here is evaluating to a negative value. So we need to find the locations on our coordinate plane where we have a negative value. We know that r is always positive, so we need to find where the y values are negative. Well, y is negative down here in the third quadrant and also over here in the fourth quadrant. I'm going to label this one here theta 1 and label this angle here theta 2. Now I'm going to look at the relationships. I know that y has to be the negative value, and that's the numerator, so I have negative 1 for both of these triangles, and we see r, which is the hypotenuse, here is root 2. Alright, I know that when I have this setup with this configuration, I know that I have a 45, 45, 90 special triangle. So what that says is that this length here also is 1, and this length here is negative 1. So now I need to figure out, well, I know this reference angle here should be 45, but I need to figure out what degree or what measure I have going from 0 to here, and then from 0 all the way to here. Well, I know this location here is 180, so what I'm going to do is take 180 and add 45 to it. So 180 degrees plus the 45 degrees, and we see that comes out to 225 degrees. And over here I know this is 0, but also 360, so I'm going to take 360 and I'm going to subtract off 45 degrees, and that'll give me this angle here in question. Well, 360 minus 45 leaves me with 315, and then I'm going to use what I know about my conversion factor. Well, to convert from degrees into radians, I know I need to multiply. Let me actually rewrite this. I know I need to multiply by pi over 180, and again, that's 180 degrees. Here, these degrees cancel, and once I simplify these fractions here, this ends up becoming 5 pi over 4. And this here is theta 1. And now when I figure out theta 2, it'll be the same thing. 315 degrees times pi over 180 degrees. The degrees cancel. And when I simplify this, this turns out to be 7 pi over 4. And this here is for theta 2. All right, now what I need to do is to write the equation in terms of x to tell me, to give me all of the solutions for this particular problem. So here I have x is equal to, I'm going to use theta 1 to begin, so is equal to 5 pi over 4 plus 2 pi. I'm using 2 pi because 2 pi is the period of the sine function, and I'm going to tack on the variable k, and k is an integer value, and that integer value allows me to get all of the solutions around the unit circle for this particular problem. So this is one of the solutions. Now I need to use theta 2 to get the second solution. So here is x is equal to 7 pi over 4. And again, I'm adding 2 pi k. So these two equations here signify all of the solutions as we go around the unit circle. Now what I want to do is actually verify these analytical results using our Texas Instruments calculator. So let's switch over. All right, with the calculator, we're going to go ahead and press y equals. And you'll notice I already have the original equation punched in, 2 sine x plus root 2. And I want to go ahead and graph that. All right, with the graph, we see that here. And now let's go ahead and zoom in so we can get a better look at what's going on. I want to keep my x values as they are. But I noticed that my y values, I'm going to make that go from a minimum of negative 1 to a maximum of 4. So I press window. And let's go down to the y minimum, which I'm going to make negative 1. And the y maximum, I'm going to make that a positive 4. And then I'm going to press graph so that we can zoom in. All right, it's going to redraw the graph. So wait a moment for that to be redrawn in. And the way this equation is set up, each one of these intercepts on the x-axis is a solution for this particular problem. Let's go ahead and use two of the solutions that we came up with. If we were to input a k value of 0, then we would be left with a solution of 5 pi over 4. So let's go to second, and then trace, and 1 for value. And let's enter 5 pi, and I want to divide by 4. And once I press enter, that indicator should come up on one of these x-intercepts. And here we see it has come up on an x-intercept. And again, we know it's on the x-intercept because we have a y value of 0. Let's go ahead now and also try a negative value. So let's use the 5 pi over 4 again. So 5 pi divided by 4. And this time I want to use a k value of negative 1. So remember, I had 2 pi times k. Well, if 2 pi times a negative 1, that gives me a negative 2 pi. So when I enter that and press and then press enter, and we see that I also have a solution back here. So each one of these intercepts is a solution, and that goes on infinitely, and we're able to capture those solutions by using that k value that's an integer. Alright, that sums up this video by Speller Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook. Subscribe to that YouTube channel, and as always, thank you guys for watching.